Christmas!
Merry Christmas!
Did you see everybody? This is the day the Lord has made. We will
Y'all slow.
This is the day the Lord has made. We will
rejoice
and be glad in it. All right, got you in the back. Hallelujah. God is good, worthy to be praised. Glad to see all your faces that you made it up an hour early this morning. Hallelujah. And we're looking for a blessed day. Hallelujah. We're going to pray now. Oh God, we come before you and we do rejoice in you. Lord, who have we but you? There is none else that we desire but you, God. Hallelujah. We thank you for this day, how you brought us. Thank you for how you've kept us. And Lord, we are just here to rejoice in you. And Lord, we look forward to what is planned for today. And we ask that you would be pleased and that you would be honored in everything that we do. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Amen.
Turn to the back of our hymnals to number 637. 637. Responsive reading. Christmas. Are you willing to forget what you have done for others and to remember what others have done for you? To ignore what the world owes you and to think what you owe the world?
We are willing with the help of God.
To put your rights in the background and your duties in the middle distance and your chances to do a little more than your duty in the foreground?
We are willing with the help of God.
To see that your fellow men are just as real as you are. And to try to look behind their faces to their hearts, hungry for joy.
We are willing with the help of God.
To close your book of complaints against the management of the universe and look around you for a place where you can sow a few seeds of happiness. Are you willing to do these things even for a day?
We are willing with the help of God.
Then you can keep Christmas. Are you willing to believe that love is the strongest thing in the world? Stronger than hate, stronger than evil, stronger than death, and that the blessed life which began in Bethlehem, and the blessed life which began in Bethlehem 1900 years ago is the image and brightness of the eternal love?
We are willing with the help of God.
Then you can keep Christmas. And if you keep it for a day, why not? Always.
Oh, Good morning.
I'll be reading the Christmas story, part one, from Luke, chapter 2, verses 1 through 7. And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And this taxing was first made on Cyrenius, was the governor of Syria. And all went to be taxed, everyone in his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
Shepherds abiding in the field,
keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring to you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. You shall find babe wrapped in swaddling cloths, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. Amen.
King James Version. And it came to pass As the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said one to another, let us now go even unto Bethlehem and see this thing which is come to pass, which the Lord hath made known unto us. And they came and haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. And when they had seen it, they made known abroad the saying which was told them concerning this child. And all they that heard it wondered at those things which were told them by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. Verse 20, and the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen as it was told unto them. Verse 20, and the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen as it was told to them. Amen.
Praise you, Jesus.
Amen. There was a question that was asked many years ago. We all have a testimony, we all have something good to say that God has done. The question was asked of Mary. Did she really know of the child that she was giving birth to? When I think about all that God has brought us through, I turn that question back around and say, do we know the God whom we truly serve?
Baby boy would one day rule the nation.
of your holy name is the great, the great.
I'm having technical problems over here.
Praise the Lord again.
Well, you guys seem to not be having any fun, not enjoying yourselves, because it's just praise the Lord. And you know, I mean, we're here because of Jesus. And this is Sister Marshallese Dern, and she just walked in, so save me from having to make up her story. Because I was going to have to. Her story will probably be very similar to mine, since we were, not telling her age, but we were born the same year, in the same country, with similar experiences. But I'll give her a chance to get herself together and come up and share. We're going to have today three different people who are going to tell memories of Christmas, and we're going to start off with Sister Marshallese Corbin. So she will not catch her breath. She will just have to do it just off the cuff. Praise the Lord. But I'm sure she's prepared to tell you about her experiences of Christmas before or ago.
Good morning, Sister Marshall. Just calm yourself down, girl.
I am. Oh, okay. Just enjoy that over there with that door pulling, pulling.
Oh, my goodness.
I don't know.
But the effectual, fervent door of is open unto you.
Yes. So, most of you, if not all, know that about the facts of all this talking about Barbados. So, y'all know that I was born there also. But growing up on Christmas in Barbados was a happy time for us. Happy. Because we know coming around that time, your mother is going to get you some new things. She goes down to the city and you know you're going to get some new shoes. If you're lucky, you get to go downtown. Otherwise, you have to put your foot on that string or a piece of cord and she'll dry your feet out. That's how you get your shoes sometimes. Then they do a lot of cleaning. You think the house wasn't clean for the year. All the curtains are taken down. The coverings for the chairs are taken off. All that stuff, and it's packed up because you're getting new ones. Nothing is going to be done until today, which is Christmas Eve. Christmas Eve night, sometimes you're still putting up curtains. Nobody can see what color they're putting up early, so they went late to put the curtains up. She did a lot of baking too. And baking wasn't done with the electric mixer. It was done by hand. You had to mix that sugar and butter together and mix. And the flour, everything, and the eggs to make that pudding. That pudding used to be good.
real good. So we did all the cleaning and everything, but then we go to church. 5 a.m. in the morning, not 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock, 5 a.m. to go to church. And then if you have some new friends that belong to the Anglican, you also go up to their midnight mass. And then you come now get a couple hours of sleep and you go to your church. Because if you go to them, you better be ready to go to yours when your time comes. So when we do Christmas morning, Christmas at church, then you know we come home, enjoy the rest of the day. Some people used to go down to the park. They'd have all this music, Christmas music and things, people from different churches, everybody would meet in the park. And then after that, they go home and enjoy their meal. This is just a little short version of what people in Barbados does for Christmas. I guess Jean has her own story, Rosalyn has her own story, and the pastor also has his own story. So anyhow, that's my little piece of a Christmas growing up in Barbados. Thank you.
Jesus,
Good morning.
Good morning. And
Merry Christmas to all. But before I start, I just want to give the Lord a high note of praise for touching me in my body. A couple Sundays ago, I didn't even know it was Sunday. My Christmas memories. Christmas is my favorite time of the year. The colorful lights and decorations all help to build the excitement of the holiday season. As a child, my parents would drive us through the best lit up neighborhoods so we could see all the beautiful lights and their lawn decorations. I also look forward to having a white Christmas, anxious to use our new sleds we would get as a Christmas gift. The excitement of waking up early Christmas morning and running downstairs to see what gifts were under the tree for me, whether it was a new bike, skates, a chatty Cathy baby doll, or lots of clothes. It was a happy, joyful time. Also, there was always a bowl of fruits and nuts on the living room table that morning.
Yes.
I always look forward to the Christmas program that was held at the High Street Church of God the Sunday before Christmas. My mother would always have a beautiful new dressy dress made in satin or velvet with a crinkle slip under it. And if you don't know what a crinoline slip was, it was a starchy like slip that made our dresses sit out so we could twirl around and, you know, be prissy. Okay. A crinoline slip under it. Black patent leather T-strap shoes or a pair of Mary Janes that you wore with either tights or lacy frilly socks. My brother Billy and Ronnie and I sang in the children's choir directed by Sister Clara Woods. She would joyfully direct us singing Silent Night, Joy to the World, and other Christmas songs. My Sunday school teacher would lead us upstairs to the classroom behind the Pennington Hall. Those of you that don't know what Pennington Hall was, before the fire, we had, the building was called Pennington Hall, and it was upstairs. So we would my Sunday school teacher would lead us upstairs into the classroom behind the Pennington Hall stage. We even had a stage. And line us up. The backstage door would open, and we would walk up the steps onto the stage with the colorful floodlights. We would look at the congregation in awe and nervously say our Christmas speeches. Sometimes we would have a part in a play telling the Christmas story of the birth of Jesus Christ, our Savior. We would dress up like shepherds, angels, and wise men. Oh, what great memories.
Yeah.
For the Sunday morning service, the children's choir would get the chance to actually march in with the senior choir. Back in the day, the senior choir would march in, and we would see them every Sunday. So Christmas time, we got to come in with them. We were so excited and proud to be marching in with the choir as they sang, "Let Mount Zion Rejoice." The children's part was, "That ye may tell it to generations, that ye may tell it to generations following." Even though back then I thought it was following me. I feel so blessed to have been brought up in a Christian home with both of my parents and loved up and nurtured, at the High Street Church of God.
Yes.
Being taught the real meaning of the Christmas season at an early age was so important. For unto us
a child was born. Unto us a son was given, and his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. And I leave with you John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. Christ was born. Hallelujah. And we are to go tell it on the mountain. Hallelujah. And so we can be prepared to go as a church. We are gathering, putting our funds together, so we're going to get ready for our offering. Amen. Hallelujah. This is the fourth Sunday, so the plate will be for our youth department. Hallelujah. This is to see what we look forward to when we can have the children marching in or doing something again. And you be sure to share that with them again and get that excitement. We praise the Lord. We praise the Lord. Hallelujah. 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 I hope you've been blessed, and I hope that you are getting the Christmas story. So I'm going to ask everyone to stand, and we're going to come from the back. We're going to ask you to start in the back, come down the side aisles and up the center aisle. Amen. Oh, I'm reminding you, if you have brought your envelope for Christ's birthday, also put it in the plate. If you have your offering for Christ's birthday, you can put it in the plate. Brother Tommy is assisting with the ushers.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. So praise the Lord. And I just want to remind you all that next Sunday is the last Sunday of the year, and our men are in charge, and they will be having a light dinner after service. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And so we're excited about our time of fellowship and celebrations. Hallelujah. Celebrating after service today with the women downstairs. So I hope everybody is prepared to stay.
Thank you.
saints. It's good to be in the house of the Lord again. Merry Christmas to everybody. I want to thank God first for being raised by a godly man. And I guess that's the gist of my Christmas story, the most biggest part of it. Back when I was 11, my sisters were 9, my mother passed away. So at Christmas, we really didn't know what to expect. We were hoping for the best, but who knows. And my father used to like to decorate. Anybody who knew my father, he loved decorating. Amen. And going into the Christmas holidays, he didn't do much decorating. So we were like, what's going to happen? So that particular Christmas morning, my sisters came down, banged on my door. Come on, Dad, it's Christmas, let's go. We charged downstairs, all we saw was bicycles and toys and all this stuff, and the house was all decorated, and Dad was lying on the couch snoring. As soon as we hit that bottom step, hey, wait up. No, I got to take some, he loved taking pictures too. Got to take some pictures, I'm tired. Y'all go back upstairs for an hour. Like, what? Go back upstairs for an hour? So, can you imagine? 11-year-old and 2 9-year-olds sitting on the steps for an hour looking at all these toys across the room and listening to Dad snoring. So, but that was just one of the Christmas memories that I had. I was telling Dave about it, and he asked me to come and share that memory with you. You know, I mean, Sister Seeger brought back a whole lot of memories with the church. And when she said Sister Woods directing the choir, she had a song speech back then. If you had it in you, she's gonna pull it out. You know, and we remember certain times of the year with a youth choir. We didn't have a children's choir.
Yeah.
We did. We remember the children's choir. I remember the youth choir we had. We used to get to march in with the senior choir. Oh, okay, that was.
But that's,
yeah, that was. Yeah. So that's the gist of the story I came up with.
Christmas. I'm here on behalf of the Christian Women Collection, and today we're talking about love. And if you're talking about love, you should go to 1 John chapter 3, and I'm reading from King James Version, verse 16.
Amen.
Hereby perceive we the love of God, because he laid down his life for us, and we ought to lay down our lives for the brother. We ought to. My husband always tells me that he's not laying down his life for me. But he loves me. But that's the extent to where we should be. God loved us so much that he laid down his life for us. And we ought to, so we have somewhere to go. King James Version says, this is how we know what love is. Jesus Christ laid down his life for us, and we ought to lay down our lives for our brethren and sisters.
Amen.
Never say that we necessarily do it, but this is where we need to attain onto. The love of God. It is more than how you feel, and it's more than what you hear.
Yes.
It comes with action.
Yes.
And it comes with what you see.
Yes.
Verses 17 and 18 says, if your brother and sister is in need and you have something and you don't even have pity for him, where's your love?
Yes.
It's more than saying, oh, I love you. I have a teacher at school who says that all the time. It drives me crazy. Because then I hear the other things she says to the kids,
yes,
when the kids are not there. And it's like, your knees just shut up. I say to myself, because there's no love there. And she says it in front of the principal, vice principal, in front of the parents. There's no love there. Love is more than what you say.
Amen.
It goes beyond you. It goes beyond your rights. It goes beyond your duties. Love overcomes hate.
Yes.
Evil, even death. And it's fitting that when we're talking about Christ, we talk about love.
Yes, yes.
Because Christ was love. The first Sunday Advent, we talk about hope. Then we went into peace, then joy and love. And then Christ. I think they have the orders reversed. First thing is Christ.
Yes.
The love that comes from God,
yes,
from Jesus Christ, who exhibit true love that he would go beyond himself,
yes,
to give us what we need.
Yes.
There is something that we need to attain unto. And from the love of God, we have hope, peace, and joy. So I'm going to light the middle candle now, the Christ. And without the middle candle, everything else can't work. But we're thanking God for his love that brings us that joy, that love, and that peace.
Amen.
I want to move so that you can see it, because this is what you have to do as Christians. You have to light that candle of Jesus Christ so others can have that peace and love and joy.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Christ had a wake and pray. His bloody sweat ran down your face. They came and with a kiss they will betray.
And Pilate and his government, they mocked you, beat you, crowned your head. They led you up the hill to hold you up.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
You might wonder why we chose that selection for this day. And it's all about the Christ of Christmas. For he came to save his people from their sins. And it was all encompassing, not just in his lowly manger birth, but it ran through all the way to his lonely, cruel death. Why is it that we celebrate Christmas? It's because Jesus, son of Joseph and Mary, the same Jesus of Bethlehem. And by the way, there is no silent night in Bethlehem today. Because Bethlehem and the land of Judah is under siege today.
Yes.
Bethlehem is not singing of Jesus. Unfortunately, Bethlehem never sings of Jesus. Because neither the Jews nor the Palestinians accept him as their Lord and Savior. But we, the Gentiles, have seen a great light. And so we should be happy because He came to his own received him not, but to such as would receive him, he's given us life, he's given us health and strength and blessings. Of course, there are some people in Jerusalem and in Palestine that accept him, but the people in general, you know, the Jews are still looking for their Messiah to come. And he's going to come a second time and they'll still be looking for the first. But we who know the Christ of Christmas, I want to encourage us to focus on Christ.
Yes.
We heard our brother, and thank you, my dear friend, Brother Teddy, for sharing that childhood story. Yes. Actually, thank all of those who shared. It was beautiful. Sister Didi, what kind of doll was that?
Chatty Cathy.
Woo, that was a new one to me. I never knew of Chatty or Cathy, so I don't know Chatty Cathy doll, but it was beautiful to hear. I assume she was beautiful. And to hear, what's that? The first talking doll, see? Yeah, I was in the culture. By the time you get a talking doll in our culture, you probably had talking families. Yeah, we didn't have that in Barbados. So it's good to hear what you've had. And sorry, my dear brother, that you had to sit at the top of the stairs for an hour before you could get to enjoy the gifts that you were anticipating. You surely enjoyed those gifts that day when you got your hands on them. We think a lot about the gifting and the receiving of gifts, and I don't want to put that down. I don't want to say that we have to not give and receive gifts, because I'm happy to receive. So I'm not going to say don't give gifts. It's good to enjoy all of Christmas. But spend some time to focus on the Christ of and in Christmas. There's no Christmas without Christ.
Amen.
Just think about that. I mean, I know it's corny, I guess, but it's obvious. You cannot have Christmas without Christ. And we need to make sure that we're focusing, especially we who have seen the great light. It said that they were walking in darkness. The people were in darkness. But a light came and shone. And this light became the light of the world. This light became the light to guide us into redemption.
Yes. Yes.
And not to guide us by just spotting a light, but the carrier who is the light walked right into our darkness and right through our darkness and all the way through the grave, but death could not keep him in the grave.
Thank you, Lord.
So see, we are celebrating today. We are celebrating the birth of Christ, but you can't, it's all historical. So we know the ending of the story. So we can't just talk about the birth and Bethlehem and the manger, all that's wonderful, but all of that has to be taken in light of the life of Christ. Yes. And the life of Christ was one to shine light upon everyone that he came in contact with. The deaf started to hear. The blind got sight, they could see. The lame could walk. The dumb could speak. That's the Christ of Christmas. That's the Christ that we are celebrating today, the one who is able, in spite of where we find ourselves, to shine light upon us and to bless us. So I want to just remind you today, and this is one of the very few times it takes sometimes 10 years before we have Christmas Eve on a Sunday. But this is a beautiful time because we can have the Christmas Eve and enjoy the Christmas spirit. We enjoy High Street way before my time. has always done a wonderful job at Christmas, because I've heard all the stories. I've heard it from Sister Philmon and others, and the Reeds. And Sister Dee Dee just took us back all the way to Pendleton Hall. You know, many of us here don't have a clue about Pendleton Hall. I've seen pictures, so I have a clue, but I've never been in Pendleton Hall. But High Street is known for its celebration of Christmas. And then in my terms with you, we've had the Messiah that kind of starts off our Christmas thinking, our Christmas feeling. And it's something that really excites me. I spend a lot of time, and my wife pointed out that I spend too much time in the Messiah. And of course, I say to myself, well, how you can spend too much time on the Messiah? That was my comeback, you know. After all, it's the Messiah. But I just, there's so much to do for Messiah. But from October, I am focusing on the Christ of Christmas.
Amen.
And I want to encourage us today, just continue to put Christ in Christmas. I remember my dad was very annoyed when we started putting Xmas.
Yes.
And he refused to do it. And he said, everybody sent him a card, but Xmas, he wasn't taking it. I said, well, you should open the card first. Because when you see the gift, you will ignore the X. I never agreed with him because X is a symbol of Christ. But I know where his heart was. His thing was, don't remove Christ from Christmas. And since we remove him so easily, you know, we're thinking about, from Thanksgiving, we're thinking about Black Friday, Cyber Monday, and all of the sales that will happen all the way up to today. And again, I tell you, saints, let's use the world to bless us. So buy all of your stuff when it's cheaper. Nothing wrong with that. But don't buy stuff because it's cheap. There's a difference, right? You buy what you know you want, what you've been looking at and hoping for, because it's a cheaper price today. So this is the best time to buy it. But don't buy it because it's cheaper. It has to be something that you want. It has to be something that you want to give or you want for yourself. Don't go out there. I remember, and I'm going to close because I'm getting off my idea, but I remember my uncle used to fret with his wife because she used to buy a whole lot of stuff, and he would ask her, well, why did you buy it? And her answer was, it was on sale. And so they used up their garage, they used up their den, they used up everything to house all the stuff because she kept buying stuff because it was on sale. Let's not get into that mindset that we are spending and overspending just because it's on sale. Use it wisely, but let Christ be the one to guide your pocketbook, your wallet, even in your spending. Even if you don't have to give me a gift because, hey, you just can't afford it, praise the Lord. If Pastor says that don't extend yourself, that's fine, because we need to make sure that we keep Christ in Christmas. He has to be our focus. He is the one who died on the cross for us so that we can say hallelujah, so that we can say praise the Lord, so that we can be redeemed. So now because of Christ, we are the redeemed. Our sins have been washed away. No one was able to carry and bear our sins until Christ came. And so we are celebrating the Christ of Christmas. We're celebrating the Redeemer. We're celebrating the one who is Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, and Prince of Peace. And you know, there was a song that used to say, what the world needs now is love. I'm saying what the world needs now is peace. We have no peace. And as I said last week, no Jesus, no peace. But the K-N-O-W Jesus is the K-N-O-W peace. So with that, we celebrate Christ. Amen?
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Praise.
I want to thank everyone who is here, who has participated. I left my program, so let me borrow yours, I'll give it back. So I want to make sure I go right down the list. I want to thank Sister Poole for being here and for ready to make sure that everybody is doing their thing. And she gave our invocation. Thanks, Sister Jean, for the reading. Brother Lawrence, Stella, and Sister Jackie for the scripture readings.
Amen.
Thank Brother Leroy for that wonderful Mary, Did You Know?
Amen.
Thank Karen for Oh Holy Night. Thank Sister Marshallene, Sister Deatra, and Brother Teddy for their wonderful memories of Christmas. So we praise the Lord for all of you. Before you go, I want to see, oh, the girls are out already. I was going to ask them to help me, but they're out. Let them stay out. Let them enjoy their time, their downtime. It's so beautiful, one laying on the other. It's so beautiful. So, Brother Joey is here. I'm going to ask Joey and Julian to come and help me. I can't get the little ones or get the big ones. We always want to give you something to commemorate a memory of Christmas and for the year. And we usually give calendars. Come on up. And we're going to give you calendars and a pen. You can get more than one calendar, you can get more than one pen, but make sure that everybody gets a calendar and a pen before you get the second one. All right? Good to see Brother Joey in the house. CWC, thank you for this season of Advent and reminding us and bringing us right up to today. And as I said, this was beautiful because today being Sunday, we're here to actually see the lighting of the Christmas, the white candle that represents Christ that we technically shouldn't see until Christmas. So this works out perfectly. That we have able to do this. So praise the Lord that we can enjoy Advent this way.
Amen.
Amen. Now, traditionally at High Street, people bring cards. We like to save you all of those stamps, and stamps are going up. They're getting more and more expensive. So, there's 53 cents for a stamp now. So what we do is you bring stamps, you bring your cards, and Sister Jean collates them, and she has this thing at the back of the church that you can go there as we adjourn and find your name, and you should see all of your cards collated for you. So we thank Sister Jean for being the postmaster mistress of High Street. So she puts together those cards.
Never mind.
All right.
Praise the Lord.
The CWC also has some collations for us. So when we adjourn, we can go downstairs to the fellowship hall, and it's the CWC Christmas party, and all of us are invited, whether we are CWC or not. So, but it's their party time. So, once we adjourn, we can go there and enjoy. We can all crash the CWC Christmas party this year. So we will be there. All right, let's stand so we can be adjourned. Praise the Lord. Again, this is a beautiful day. The Lord has made. We have rejoiced. And we are glad in it. Father, we thank you for this wonderful day you have given us.
Yes, Lord.
We thank you for actually the beauty of the day. It's you've blessed us with a little warmer weather, and you've blessed us to be able to enjoy a nice breeze today. We thank you, O Lord, for the physical day, and we thank you for every day for your presence. Now, Lord, we pray that your blessings will go before us. Your mercies will ever hover over us.
Yes.
Your grace will be upon us, and your peace will be ours. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost, we pray. Amen. God bless you.
Amen.
It's not hard for me to head it in. No, sir, grown up because it's not going to be much shorter next year.
You put it, sir.
Those chemicals. That doesn't matter. It's not because I have a battery set. Yeah, but you know, I don't have a battery set for.